Oi, TikTok ba yan? Oi, sale. Oi. Whoa. That's good. That was beautiful.
Okay, I'm uploading now.
Uploadable, yeah.
I'm uploading.
Yeah. Go for it.
Okay, ito na.
If you had 5G, uploaded na yan, like right away.
What a segue.
Hey, I can do that too. Because today's episode is about journey to 5G.
So Mikael, for an average person like me, what is 5G? How is that different from the 4G on my phone right now?
Okay, let's rewind to the days of 1G. Take these guys out. 1G started back in the 80s, and back then you could only do analog voice calls. And then 2G came in the 90s. We had another cell tower because we could do voice calls and SMS, aka
texting.
Tama. Yes. And then with 3G, that enabled us to browse the web on our phones, which was super cool back in the day. And 4G, of course, we know this. We're streaming content all day, every day with everybody around us. And then, of course, we have 5G. This is just mind-blowing.
Mind
it opens
blowing.
Up so many possibilities.
It's crazy.
It's super exciting.
It's everything. So, parang gusto ko na ngayon mag 5G. It's fast, no?
Oh, yeah, it is. I actually have an analogy for you. Let's take these people out. So, imagine 4G is like you're on a two-lane highway, you're in your sedan, driving along with other cars. But on 5G, you're in a 10-lane highway, in your sports car.
Wow, intense! 0 to 60 in no time. Look at me, car reference.
Yeah, you know, that's actually really important because 0 to 60 is referring to latency, which is also faster in 5G.
Mm-hmm. Let's go back to the car.
One more analogy. I got you. So if speed is referring to how fast the cars are going, latency is referring to the driver's reaction to when the stoplight turns green.
Okay.
Super quick. Not as quick.
Sounds awesome! So my Instagram videos are gonna be crisp.
Yeah, they're gonna be super crispy, but 5G does have its drawbacks.
Okay.
Is that 5G has a shorter range, which means it requires more base stations to cover the same number of people in one area. Fortunately, though, there is a pro. 5G base stations and antennas are more compact, which means they're easier to install than 4G.
Okay, so thanks for telling me the pros and cons, but I still think it's pretty worth it, you know? My mobile content consumption will be on point.
Oh yeah, it definitely will be, but just wait until you hear the potential use cases for 5G. Let me give you an example.
Okay.
Think a smart city where you're having drones delivering packages to you.
Wow.
Super cool, right? This is my favorite. Self-driving cars, that's the future.
Okay, I'm game for all of that. I'm so ready. I'm gonna start saving up right now. Where's my board?
You actually might not have to save up too much because there are a lot of affordable 5G phones out right now. I know one is the Huawei Nova 7 SE. My wife has that.
Hi, wife. And my, hi, everyone.
Aww, it's okay, Janina. But anyway, stick around for the next episode if you want to know the actual use cases of 5G today.
Oh nga, Bermans na. Hi, Dad. Don't you love your favorite only daughter? You know,
very
I love
professional.
You. I'm probably gonna cut it out anyway.
And they might not. Thank you guys so much for watching. And to learn more about 5G and how it brings us closer than ever to the future, don't forget to watch Possibilities, the 5G series.
And don't forget to subscribe to the Globe on the Radar YouTube channel as well as turn on that notification bell para you guys won't miss us that much.
Galing talaga. That's Janina.
That's Mikael.
See you guys.
Bye.